right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome yourselves back, please, to the North Shore of Auckland, New Zealand, where the FIBA Under-19 Men's Championships Day 1 comes to a close here. Pool D, it's the Junior Tall Blacks against Argentina. Now, if I was to ask you what Yao Ming, Andrew Bogut, and Andrei Kirilenko have in common, well, they've all been had the ball stolen from them by Dylan Boucher. Dylan, welcome to the broadcast.
Thanks, Dan. Pleased to be here.
All right, well, here's what happened today. Iran went down by 51 points to the U.S. Spain took out Syria. Canada, well, 11 points to Australia there. And tonight is the big one here as far as this part of the earth is concerned, the New Zealand Junior Tall Blacks against the sixth-place best team on the planet, Argentina. Dylan, you've been in this situation before. You're a former Tall Black. You've got 100 games playing with the Tall Blacks. Congratulations in joining the coaching ranks with the Tall Blacks. Do some of these Junior Tall Blacks, do you think they'll make the jump to the Tall Blacks?
Yeah, this is exciting times for these guys. They're going to have, you know, the blood's going to be pumping through the veins. They're ready. They're fired up, ready for this tournament. They've got the home crowd behind them. It's exciting times for these young guys' careers, and it's like I said, it's a stepping stone onto something bigger and better. But right now, they're focused on this game and getting the win against Argentina.
Well, you know, baptism of fire, they're behind the eight ball. You can use any saying you want, but at the end of the day, these boys right here, Josh Bloxham right on down to Rob Lowe. Now, interesting enough, Rob Lowe, he's the tallest junior tall black at 2'1", which is 6 feet 11. He's also the youngest junior tall black, just turning 18 last month. What can we expect from the big man down low?
Yeah, I mean, Rob's been, from talking to the coaching staff, Rob's been playing outstandingly well in the lead-up game, so they're expecting big things from this tournament, but he's used to playing guys a lot smaller than himself. He's going to come up against guys that are the same height, if not bigger than him in this tournament, so he's going to have to bring a bit of mongrel to his game and play strong inside for the Tall Blacks to even have a chance to be able to compete with this team.
Well, if there's one thing New Zealand have, it's plenty of mongrel. And these boys here, they are untested. The reason how they got through here to the FIBA 16 tournament, well, they are the host nation, so they get an automatic berth here. Now, Argentina, how did they get here? 2008, the FIBA America Under-18 champions, they were the gold medalists. So, yes, in fact, the Junior Tall Blacks are very much right up against it. Mateo Gaynor, Andreas Landoni plays professional basketball, so we've got a few basketballers on this very loose Argentinian team, and they are a bunch of athletes.
Yeah, absolutely. Argentina are one of the informed teams coming into this tournament. They've had success at these sort of tournaments before. They're playing extremely well as a unit, and they've had this unit together for quite a while now, so expect some very polished stuff to be going out there, some slick passing, and some great offense to be displayed out there.
Yes, and well, barring Richie Edwards and Dion Brewster, the Junior Tall Blacks have been in camp for 18 months. So they have been preparing for this for a year and a half. And it's all up to tonight. The world is watching.
The national anthem of Argentina.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of New Zealand.
place is rocking, ladies and gentlemen, the North Shore Event Center. The Kiwis have come out in droves here.
And now, ladies and gentlemen.
And now coming up, Dylan, I want you to tell everybody in our worldwide audience here what exactly is coming up, the haka. This is something that New Zealand sporting teams do.
Absolutely. This is something that's tradition to New Zealand teams, and you know, it's basically laying a challenge down to the Argentinian boys. So let's have a look and see what they got. Talking about, these boys are fired up, ready to go. Great job by Josh Bloxham firing his boys up. These fellas are ready, they're ready to go.
All right, well, with a game there must be referees. Your referees for tonight's extravaganza, Mr. Mohamed Alamari from Kuwait, Mr. Thomas Jasavicius from Lithuania, and Mr. Sasa Pollock from Slovenia. Kenny McFadden, another expat, played at Washington State University. He was an import down here in the New Zealand National Basketball League, but he has put a lot into this game. Here we go now. Dion Prooster, Rob Lowe, Logan Van Beek, Richie Edwards, and Brooke Rusko. That will be the starting five here now for the junior tall blacks. What do you see a strength being in that starting five, Dylan?
Obviously, Rob Lowe. Rob Lowe, like I talked earlier, he's been playing outstanding in the last couple of warm-up games. They'll be looking to dominate inside early. This is probably one of the few teams that New Zealand match up similar height-wise to these guys. So, you know, be looking for big things inside early to free up the shooters later on in the game.
All right, we get Fabian Ramirez Barrios. Andres Landoni, we're going to watch him. He plays professional ball. Pablo Orlietti, Juan Manuel Fernandez, and Mantis Nosedel. If you don't have size, you've got to have speed. I think both these teams are lightning quick. They've got a couple of big guys per side. But once again, Argentina, sixth on the planet back in 2007, the last time FIBA did this with the under 19. And there's some interested spectators there. Chris Tupu, a former tall black. He's now a coach in the New Zealand National Basketball League. And the man to his left, Peyro Cameron. He is epic, is Peyro Cameron. And look at this. The Honorable Right Prime Minister of New Zealand, John Key, is here as well. So it's all happening at the North Shore Event Center here in Auckland, New Zealand. And we are tipped off here. And we'll go out of bounds. Rob Lowe did get the jump there, but the Argentinians will get first use of the ball here.
Expect to see a pretty polished Argentinian team. They're going to come down, be patient on their first play, and try and get something, a good, quick, easy shot.
Fabian Barrios, around it goes. Andres Landoni, back to Fernandez. Shot up from Nosedel, no good. And the Kiwis have the rock.
That's the best possible result for the Tall Blacks to force a contested jump shot. And, you know, quite frankly, that was a brick. So, you know, that's a good start for the junior Tall Blacks.
I love it when you're frank, Dylan. All right, Brooke Rusko with it now. We'll find Richie Edwards, Dion Prooster now. Low. Prooster top of the key, goes to penetrate. Nice little floating shot, rims out, no good. Fernandez with the rebound. Here come Argentina. We've noticed the first couple of quarters here throughout the games today, it seems to be a bit of a settling down period. A lot of turnovers and a really low shooting percentage.
Yeah, absolutely. I think a lot of teams are getting used to it. It's a brand new molten ball they're using, so this team's getting used to that. Throughout all the games, we've seen guys struggle from the perimeter early on.
Fabian Barrios with a tip in there will get the first two.
Seen some very good ball pressure here from Argentina.
Yep. Brooke Rusko will bring it up now for the junior Tall Blacks. Find Richie Edwards. Richie Edwards, one of the, well, I guess you could say settled in America.
Oh. Look at this! Can you believe it? The first 2 points for the junior Tall Blacks in a FIBA competition is a massive set down. I love it.
Great move by Rob Lowe again, establishing their presence inside early. That'll do the world of good for this guy's confidence. He's going to be pumped now, fired up, ready to go.
He's not the only one. Fantastic stuff from the junior Tall Blacks here early. As Argentina now look to settle things down, Orlietti with it down low. Richie Edwards on hand, a bit of a mismatch. He's going to spin a little hook shot. Nice shot from him.
We need to
Pablo
get some
Orlietti
outside in there. The junior Tall Blacks can't let the guy take, you know, four or five dribbles and make a post move. We've got to have someone digging the ball out of there.
Richie Edwards now brings it up for the junior Tall Blacks. Around it goes to Dion Prooster. Looking for Edwards. Finds Lowe. Lowe gets it. He's going to sink a three. Will he? That's off the mark. No good.
Junior Tall Blacks being very patient on offense, which is good to see. Not rushing their shots.
Yes, get a good positive look, high percentage shot early in the game. And there's a shot missed. An absolute duck missed by Pablo Orlietti. Here comes Rusko. He'll catch a foul, and it almost goes in on a very strange angle. Good great work from him.
Great strong move by Brooke Rusko. He's going to be looking to take two free throws here. Oh, the referee's caught it on the ground. Let's see what they've got on the out-of-bounds play here.
And that will be taken away by Andreas Landoni. And here come the Argentinians once again. Fernandez with it. Top of the key, Brooke Rusko on him. They go baseline. Nice stuff down low. He sticks with it, does Fabian Barrios. But initially, good defense there by Dion Prooster and Rob Lowe, down low.
Absolutely, we've got to take care of those second chance shots. We can't let the Argentinian boys get offensive rebounds.
Dion Prooster gets the, look at this beautiful pass to Logan Van Beek from Dion Prooster.
Great basketball.
And I'll tell you, good people, the Argentinians came out here and they were loose as a goose, dancing around, but they seemed to lose their smiles after that haka.
Absolutely, I think the haka has put a little bit of fear into these guys. They seem to be playing with some confidence out there.
Logan Van Beek, great defense from him. Dion Prooster with it now. Low. Van Beek. That's a little
great
short.
Great hustle play. Great
fantastic
hustle play.
Fantastic. And steps out of bounds, unfortunately. It will be Argentina's ball, but
it's one thing New Zealand do very well is they work hard on offensive rebounds. They work hard. They hustle. They do all the little things that are going to win this basketball game.
No Sedell with it now for Argentina. Kicks it back to Fernandez. Inside it goes to Orlietti, and he will throw it out of bounds. I do believe it did go off a junior Tall Black, so they will have possession here with 10 seconds left on the shot clock.
I think Kenny McFadden's going to be reasonably happy with how the boys are going at this stage. You know, they seem to be executing well. The defense is strong. They've given nothing easy up.
Fernandez with the rock now, looks to penetrate. Rusko working on him, and a beautiful block by Brooke Rusko down low. Great. And the junior Tall Blacks are just locking things down on the defensive side of things. Richie Edwards, look at this! Holy moly!
Great play. Silky smooth. Weaved his way through the defense, scooped it up with the right hand.
Now for any of you scouts out there, that is EW. We know that Richie Edwards and Dion Prooster are looking to play school ball in the States now.
Rob Lowe doing a great job clogging up the lane, making everything tough for their guards.
Not an easy shot at all by Mantis Nosedow. He will be fouled in the process, however. But
in all the games we've seen here today, this has been one of the hottest starts for both teams, really.
Absolutely. I think New Zealand team is going to be extremely happy with how they've started this game. The defense is very tough inside, and they don't want to give up anything easy, as I said earlier. So make the Argentinian team earn everything from the line or from the perimeter.
Beautiful scooping shot by Richie Edwards there. Mantis Nosedal will miss the first offering from the charity stripe.
Feeling the nerves a little bit, I think. Crowd's playing a little bit of part in this game early. It's great to see.
And he will sink the second one. 6-6, we're all knotted up. Check that, 7-6, Argentina's up by one. Wishful thinking, perhaps, but the junior tall blacks have the rock at the moment. Dion Prooster is directing traffic.
Some token full-court man-to-man pressure from the Argentinian side.
Richie Edwards with it. He's going to pop up a three, and that is off the mark. And here come the Argentinians now. Fernandez will kick it off to Barrios. Now it's Landoni with it. Around the horn it goes. Nosedal goes to penetrate. And I just like the look of the collapsing defense of the junior tall blacks. They are not going to give away any easy buckets. And if they don't do that today, they're ahead of most of the teams that play today.
Absolutely. Making the Argentinian team earn everything from the stripe, like I said earlier. That's the key to starting a game. Make nothing easy. Get them frustrated and make them start jacking it up from the perimeter.
Josh blocks him into the game for Logan Van Beek for the junior tall blacks. Andreas Landoni at the line here for Argentina. He's supposed to be the next big thing out of Argentina. Has played professional in a league over there for a few years now.
Again, we're seeing, you know, nerves early. Guys are shooting short on their shots. Again, with that new ball, it's very tough to shoot. It's tough to get used to.
He will sink the second one. And look at this, full court pressure now by the Argentinians. Quite a change up. Richie Edwards will bring it over half court.
Junior tallback's not having any trouble with the pressure so far.
Dion Prooster back to Richie Edwards. Looking for help.
Gonna need to get a shot up here.
3 seconds left, he's gotta put it up. That's off the front of the rim, almost went in, but look at that, Lowe down there. And he will catch a foul. Good work from Rob Lowe.
Great job on the boards. Rob's working extremely hard in there. He's got to conserve his energy a little bit. He's going to be playing some big minutes throughout this game.
And that's a bit of a coach killer when you got a team down to 1 second left on the shot clock and bang, they've got a fresh 24 all of a sudden.
Absolutely. It's those little hustle plays, the one percenters in basketball that are really important in games like this.
Richie Edwards with a miss there. Now here comes Argentina. Nosedal with it. Out to Andreas Landoni, off the rim, no good. Richie Edwards is fighting for the rebound. It will go to Argentina. They'll get a fresh 24 as Christian Cortez has it now for Argentina.
A little bit of a mismatch on the wing here. They're going right to it, trying to go at Rob Lowe.
Nosedal, he is quick as lightning, going right by Rob Lowe.
Great move.
Rob was smart there not to pick up the foul.
Yeah, that's one of the things, Dan, that the junior tallbacks have to be careful of, you know. Rob is their tallest player.
Oh, would you look at that from Dion Prooster! And one! Lands on his back in the process, he's okay. Great body control in the air from Dion Prooster.
Great set play, through Rob Lowe on the high post, looks back door, nice bounce pass, and one.
These junior tallbacks are looking relatively polished as Dion Prooster looks to convert the three-point play here.
What I like is the confidence. They're playing with a lot of confidence out there, and it's great to see. Another hustle play that we talked about. Now, these one percenters, they're keeping the junior tall blacks confidence up, and they're keeping them in this game. Or, in fact, you know, I feel, even though the score's not indicative of it, I feel like they've got the upper hand so far in this game.
They certainly do. Lowe with the rock now, the youngest member and tallest member of the junior tall blacks, and he just makes it happen down there in the paint.
That's pretty. Rob is doing a great job out there for the Tall Blacks so far. He's setting the standard.
Now, you set the standard back in 2002, my good man. They're just following your lead. All right, Argentina with it now. In the corner it goes. Christian Cortez will wrap it around. Gonzalez. Shot. Good. I love the way he left his hands in the air. He knew that was going in the second he left his hands.
Yeah, again, you can't leave those shooters open. They're doing a great job collapsing, but they have to remember to get out to those shooters.
Mantis Nosedal there, making no mistake from outside. Richie Edwards finds Morgan Nathan.
Argentina look like they've turned up the pressure a little bit.
Lowe with it. And he's looking for a rolling Morgan Nathan. Shot no good. Gets his own rebound. Nathan off the glass. Yes!
Great job. Again, I can't harp on it anymore about it. You know, the offensive rebounds, you know, the loose balls, that's going to be the key to the success in this game.
All right, here come the Argentinians now.
Got a zone defense here by the Junior Tall Blacks. Kenny McFadden talked earlier how he's going to mix the defenses up. We've seen the first sign of it here.
Shot from the corner for three, no good. And that will remain Argentina's ball. We look at number 10 out there for Argentina. Okay, Luciano Gonzalez, he was born on January 1st, 1990. So if he was born a day later, he would not be in this tournament. He would not be eligible to be in this tournament. You have to have been born January 1st, 1990 or later. So there's a few players right on the cusp here that made this tournament by a day or two.
Back to man-to-man defense now again, keeping the Argentinian team guessing.
Shot from outside, rims out. These are tight rims here at the North Shore Event Center. And they will get another offensive rebound.
Back-to-back offensive rebounds now for the Argentinians. Junior Tall Blacks have to do a better job on the boards.
Christian Cortez goes by Josh Bloxham, and he will get pinged with a foul. And, well, just 2:04 left to go here in the first. And New Zealand only down by one to the sixth best team in the world, Argentina. They weren't expecting this. And, wow, that's another quick foul on Josh Bloxham. Check that travel. I thought Josh might have got pinged with a second quick one there. That would have been bad news. I'll take the travel.
I think the Junior Tall Blacks need to key in a little bit more on their rebounding. At both ends, Rob Lowe seems to be the only one in there doing a lot at the moment. So I think we need to pack. We're packing it in on defense. I think they need to get down there and rebound as well. Take care of the ball before they worry about going down the other end.
Yeah, good point. Morgan Nathan finds Dion Prewster. Richie Edwards now, and there's a screaming Morgan Nathan. Didn't look likely. Here's the counterattack now. Gonzalez. Nice inside work. Razio, no good.
Great defense.
Fantastic work by the Junior Tall Blacks, and they refused to be pushed around here tonight.
They're really causing a lot of frustration in the Argentinian players, and that's exactly what they want to do. They want to play that spoiling type of basketball on the inside, make everything tough.
All right, Junior Tall Blacks now looking to potentially take the lead here. Josh Bloxham. Down the horn it goes. David Beck into the game now. And we've got a foul inside on one of the Argentinians.
I think the referees are trying to tidy the game up a little bit. There's a little bit of holding going on. I think they're just trying to tidy the game up, showing the players that, you know, they're going to call these little fouls, bumping fouls. Not really much in that at all, but, you know, the ref's just trying to tidy it up.
All right, Junior Tall Blacks now with a fresh 24-second clock.
Nice move by Beck.
Beautiful. David Beck spins around and gets two on the baseline.
Again, anytime you can sub in the game and make your first shot, that's going to do a world of confidence for David. He's going to be looking now to pick up the D, clog up the inside a little bit, get some rebounds.
New Zealand is in the lead here, 14-13, with just 1 minute left to go in the first quarter. Christian Cortez for the Argentinians trying to get by Bloxham. Finds Gonzalez, but I believe that was a 24-second shot clock violation.
I agree.
Regardless of that, the Junior Tall Blacks look to compile this lead now. Bloxham finds Lowe into Beck. Beck loses the rock. And here come Christian Cortez.
Oh, great defensive play.
Oh, fantastic. Luciano Gonzalez, nice finish. David Beck now brings it up for the Junior Tall Blacks. He's immediately double-teamed, and he will find the ball handler in Josh Bloxham.
Junior Tall Blacks have done a good job on the pressure defense, bringing it up the floor. That time, David Beck showed his skills by bringing it up the floor.
Bodies are flying down low as Rob Lowe takes it, pops it up off the glass. Holy moly, did he call the bank?
I don't think he called that, but he'll definitely take it.
Rob Lowe here with 6 points early. And let's not forget that two-handed slammer that he popped in there early, as Lissandro Razio will get the last bucket of the first quarter. But let's have a little look at this. New Zealand down by 1 point to Argentina. Argentina 17, the New Zealand Junior Tall Blacks 16.
Let's not have some fun. We're going to play Argentina, New Zealand all over again. We're putting the basketballs out.
Well, now, Dylan, what stat really jumps out at you on this first quarter?
Obviously, New Zealand has tried to set the standard early by going inside. They've taken 2 3-point shots, have been unsuccessful on both. But it's great to see they've pounded inside early, and then hopefully later on in the game that will open up for their shooters. A little bit disappointing as well as the rebounding effort. You know, with 10-7, not a big difference, but I could imagine there's a few offensive rebounds in there that, you know, Kenny McFadden wouldn't be happy about.
And they're overplaying. Let's go hard back door. All right, Deion's, Brooks, hard back door. Deion, you can stay on the post. You got to lift. Don't dribble handoff on that hand, all right? Make that pass so we can get to that on ball. One dribble, lift from that side. We can look at that high and low. But don't forget, we can enter in the corner. From the corner, we can go inside. If not, look to shoot it. Now, we're doing a good job on the defense, other than a couple times we allow penetration that we didn't want. Keep mixing it up between 34s and man. Don't let them get comfortable. But we can get to 13. So whoever's a plugger.
Hey, run up on the ball, force him to the sideline. Just play him to the sideline and then cut him off, and I'm going to be right there. Like, I have court or right before I have court.
Because we want to get right there.
We can't get in the middle of the court.
Hey.
Well, here he is, all 6'11" of them. The youngest junior tall black sitting down a dunk for the first 2 points ever in this competition for the junior tall blacks. And look at that.
I like
gotta love it.
I like it. I like the way, you know, Rob's looking to attack. You know, he's feeling good about himself. He's made some shots early and he's attacking inside. You know, to start the game with a dunk, or start the tournament with a dunk, what a great way for a young guy like himself to start the tournament.
Fantastic. Now, are the junior tall blacks looking up at the scoreboard going, wow, we are very much in this game right now?
Yeah, I don't think they're too surprised. I believe Kenny McFadden thought if they could play defense well, that they would hold this team. And, you know, it's only the first quarter. We're yet to see them sustain it for the whole game. But like he said in his timeout, it's very balanced with his timeout with offense and defense. They complimented the way they were playing defense. So let's look to see what they got in the second quarter.
Low with the rock at the moment. He's going to shoot it from the elbow, and that will roll in for him. He keeps getting that shooter's bounce off the front of the rim.
You would think he's played in the stadium a few times.
Fantastic. And looking down at the Argentinian bench, they just look gobsmacked at the moment. Okay, Razio with the rock now. Around it goes Fernandez. Fernandez up high. Nice work from a point guard to get that low in the paint. 2 points for him.
They need to do a better getting that help side slid across there. That guy can't get it a direct lane to the hoop.
Deion Prewster with it now for the junior tall blacks. Brooke Rusko, Edwards.
Oh, great screen. Great screen, Rob.
Brooke Rusko launches a three. Off the mark, but ooh, I thought the Argentinians might have knocked it out of bounds there, but they did not. Here they come.
Lowe is doing everything you can expect from your big man. He's giving help side defense. He's setting good screens. He's scoring inside and out. He's having a whale of a game right now.
Morgan Nathan back into the game for the junior tall blacks. And Rob Lowe will have his first rest of the night. Well deserved indeed, as Rob Lowe now sitting on 8 points.
Absolutely. Well earned rest. I think Kenny McFadden's going to probably look to rest him just for a few minutes, and then you'll probably see him coming back in.
Juan Fernandez has it now for the Argentinians.
Logan Van Beek doing a great job defensively, denying the ball.
There's a steal from Morgan Nathan. Here come the junior tall blacks.
Can't help but think the Argentinian team's a little bit rattled. They're turning the ball over, making bad decisions.
Bang! Deion Prewster hit that one from the face room, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a captain's shot. You know, he's looking to show some leadership out there, set the standard. That's a great way to start. Again, back to the zone defense.
Fantastic work from him as they try to work it inside there. Fresh 24, but again, Kenny McFadden has these guys singing his tune. Let me tell you, look at this. He is well beyond the arc there by a meter.
He's causing a lot of confusion with the switching defense. That was the idea of bringing out, changing from man to zone, confusing the team, not making them feel comfortable out there. It's working so far.
Orletti with a shot and a miss. As Richie Edwards has it now for the junior tall blacks. Great skills from him thus far. Morgan Nathan loses his footing, and he will get called with a travel, unfortunately.
No basket.
And that's one of the few turnovers that Junior Tall Blacks have had so far in this game.
You don't mind those turnovers. He's been aggressive, made an aggressive move to the hoop, finished the move, but just got caught up on the guy's foot, slid over. Tough luck.
All right, Argentina with the ball now. Razio, around the horn it goes. Fernandez for three. That bounces up and off. Richie Edwards fights for the rebound. He'll find Deion Brewster, saves it. Junior Tall Blacks now with the counterattack. Top of the key, Edwards. Nice pass into Morgan Nathan. A little bit too much traffic there, and here come the Argentinians once again. And that is good from Christian Cortez.
Kenny McFadden will not be happy about that. You know, that you don't want to leave anything to let the Argentinians get their tails up in this game. They're doing a great job so far. Again, another turnover by the Junior Tall Blacks. Just trying to force it a little bit right now. They need to be patient, go back to what they were doing in the first quarter. Be patient, execute their offense.
Right, and take those high percentage shots.
Absolutely.
Use the clock to your advantage. As Christian Cortez will bring it up here. 6:52 left to go until halftime. Just 1 point in it. The untested Junior Tall Blacks staying right with Argentina.
Great defense.
Shot from Gonzalez, no good. Orlietti's got the rebound. Another offensive rebound.
Junior Tall Blacks using a switching on-ball defense.
And doing a tightrope walk down there. And a shot will eventually go from Juan Fernandez, but good movement.
Nice floating shot from Fernandez. It's what you expect from these, you know, South American-style basketball players, the likes of Ginobili.
Brooke Rusko with it now. Finds a seam. Beautiful move, Brooke Rusko.
Brooke Rusko, known as a shooter, showing there he can put it on the floor. I would say the Argentinian team will not be wanting to get him any open looks from the three-point line. And therefore, he opens it up for himself by penetrating to the hoop. Back into the zone defense now.
They are really switching up their defenses at a frantic pace, are the Junior Tall Blacks. And we've got a foul underneath. Fresh 24 coming up here for Argentina.
Rob Lowe checking back in the game. We knew he wouldn't be out of the game long. Looking to clog up that middle again like he's done so well in the first quarter and the start of the second quarter.
Fabian Barrios back into the game as well for Argentina. Number 11 as number 10, Luciano Gonzalez takes a breather.
JTB's using a lot of switching defenses. Bit harsh for Logan Van Beek. Little guy getting caught on the big guy. Boxing out. Referee called him for a pushing foul. Going under the legs.
Foul is called. I'm not 100% sure if Logan Van Beek even saw what happened from behind.
It's tough when you're a little guy like that and you're matched up on a big guy. Did exactly what you need to do. A little bit unlucky to get pinged for the foul there.
All right. Argentina with the ball. Fernandez. Inside it goes.
Fantastic pass.
And look at that, Deion Brewster from behind with another block. 12 seconds left of the shot clock here. It'll be inbounded by Nicholas La Provitola.
Again, not doing a good job on the on ball. Lucky to get away with a miss there.
Unfortunately, another offensive rebound. Goes to the way of Argentina, just the way the ball seems to be bouncing here in this first half. A lot of movement with the ball from Argentina. Shot from outside, yes, and that will connect. Fabian Barrios for three.
Richie Edwards got a good hand up there, but it was a little bit too late. Gave the guy too much room. Nothing.
Richie Edwards with it now. Stops, pops up a three, and that will not roll in for him, as Fernandez will bring it up now.
I just think Richie Edwards needs to be a little bit more patient. He's looking to get himself involved in this game, but he's taking ill-advised shots at the moment. I think he just needs to let the offense work for itself.
And we're going to foul on the play. Junior Tall Blacks ball. And they're both on five fouls here with 4:44 left to go until halftime.
This is an important time for the Junior Tall Blacks. They want to use this last 4 minutes to really finish this half well. They want to execute well and defend extremely well. Go into the half with some positives.
Well, if you haven't heard, Puerto Rico has beaten Lithuania today, so that was a major upset. Maybe we've got another one happening here in the works. Brooks Rusko with it. He puts it up. Bang! It is a three!
Give this guy some room. He's got the hot hand. He's known for his three-point shooting. Shown displaying exactly there what he is capable of. A little bit of pressing defense coming up.
Orlietti was lucky to get rid of it. Round it goes to Nocidal. Beautiful right hand lay-in for him.
Nocidal is really hurting them with his penetration.
Here comes Richie Edwards now. Dion Brewster. Round the horn it goes.
Nocidal is all over Josh Bloxham, not giving him any room to move.
Here's Rusko again, penetrates, puts it up, off the glass. Yes!
I'll tell you what, these junior tall blacks are getting some rolls, but that's the aggressive play we're talking about. Brooke Rusko is feeling good right now. He needs a sub. He's calling for a sub now. He feels like his work's done. He's a little bit tired, needs a breather. Get some fresh legs out there.
Here's Orlietti to Nicholas Laprovitola. And we get some penetration here. Nice work, good work by Dion Brewster there.
Numbers here for the junior tall blacks. Can they make them pay?
Rusko.
Rusko. Yes! He is
and
hot.
It's a three. And that man is on fire right now.
I think he needs to wave off his sub. He's feeling good right now.
He's got the mojo happening.
It's a tough predicament as a player. You know, he's obviously feeling really good out there shooting the ball well, but he's extremely tired. Feels like he can't offer as much as he would like to on defense. Called for a sub. That's great, unselfish play by Brooke Rusko.
And check this out. Making him pay from outside, Brooke Rusko. Again. Ricky Buckrell into the game now for the junior tall blacks.
Back to his own.
Good ball movement. Laprovitola with it. Around it goes. Shot no good. And they will get yet another offensive rebound. And that's another shot from them and another offensive rebound. It's just the way the ball's bouncing here in the first half.
Argentina doing a great job on the boards right now.
Yeah, great ball movement from them, but they just can't seem to convert.
Yeah, the junior tall blacks are clogging their lane up, forcing them to take shots from the outside. And you know, it's really paying dividends for them right now with Argentina shooting a low percentage.
There's low down low. We might have been fouled, didn't get the call. And they are on the run now. Argentina.
Great hustle.
And they will get it done that time with three of them swarming around the bucket.
Buckle did a great job getting back there. Just was too many numbers in the end for Argentina.
Just 2 minutes left until halftime. And we are all knotted up here. Richie Edwards with it. Low. Thinks about a long two. Nails it!
So on the line, unfortunately. Rob Lowe is feeling good right now. He's pumped.
He's got 10 points. He's feeling it.
They're going to have to start getting a hand up on the outside. He's made three jumpers now. The Argentinians will definitely be talking about that at halftime. It should open everything up on the inside for him a little bit more.
Little stop and pop from Nocidal. No go. Dion Brewster with the rebound. And here come a very composed junior tall black team.
Absolutely.
Richie Edwards. No good.
That's a good, still a good shot from Richie Edwards within the offense. Pick and roll, left him wide open. He has to take that shot, otherwise they're gonna start sagging off him. That's the shot we need him to take.
And the corner goes to Orlietti. He's gonna put it up baseline. It will rim out.
Great box out by Buckle.
Fantastic work off the ball by the junior tall blacks, and we've got a foul called. And perhaps a get-out-of-jail-free card for Ricky Buckrell there. Lost the ball. And we've got a timeout called. Now, just for the folks at home here, Argentina has asked us not to film their timeout. So that's why we're going to be going to the junior tall blacks and Kenny McFadden all game long here.
Possession, we go 34. All right, 34 coming down. Next offensive possession, let's go hand exchange. All right? Yeah, out of bounds. All right. So we're gonna finish the half, exchanges on dead ball, breakout on missed shots. going to finish the half on 24s and 34s. All right, but make sure we understand where the shooters are. All right, hey, defense, take a
out. 1, 2, 3.
Well, junior tallbacks playing well. They did have 7 turnovers in that last quarter there, but at the end of the day, they are stride for stride with Argentina right now.
What I love is Kenny McFadden's timeout. Very deliberate in what he wants out there. That's great to see. It's great coaching, telling the guys exactly what he wants out there. There's no excuses now to not execute and not know exactly what they're doing. He was very deliberate in what he was saying in the timeout. Let's see what they come up with here.
Rusko to inbound. 21 seconds on the shot clock. Plenty of time here for the junior tall blacks. Blocks them, finds Deion Prewster.
Nice, nice high low.
Fantastic.
Great move.
Shot off the glass, no good by Morgan Nathan. Comes Argentina now. La Provitola, nice work by Richie Edwards. Nice work by Brooke Rusko.
That's beautiful.
Brooke
Rusko got his little rest in the timeout. Kenny McFadden wanted to leave it in. Leave him in, he saw he was hot.
And Argentina now starting to slam the ball around. Really can't get over what's happening to them here.
That was actually a really good foul by Richie Edwards. He stopped the play, it was gonna be a basket, so he stopped the play, knowing that they weren't in the bonus. See if they can get a final possession now to hold out for the half.
10 seconds left until the half. La Provitola with the rock.
Brewster all over him.
No Sedell in the lane. Back up to La Provitola. And
half time. Argentina 31. New Zealand 35.
A little bit of confusion here. I think the referee blew his whistle too early for the half. He's checking with the score bench, making sure that they're exactly what he thought it was.
Uh-oh, look at this. They've got the halftime people walking out onto the court.
You guys gotta
get back off the court. We still got some basketball to go.
I think the referee's saying there's 4 seconds on the clock. I think that seems a little bit too much. 1 second to put on the clock. That's more like it. Good chance for the junior Tall Blacks to get a shot up here.
Now, once again, Argentina getting the gold medal in the Americas last year. They normally hold most of their opponents below 63 points. Last year, they held the States to 64 points.
We've got a timeout here by Kenny McFadden. I think he wants to get a quality shot out of this last 1 second. In basketball, 1 second is a very long time, or 0.5 seconds is a very long time. So he feels like he can get a good long pass and an open shot down the other end. Let's see what they come up with in the timeout.
An alley-oop or something to that effect, and they could always draw the foul, absolutely.
You may even see Rob Lowe try and get something near the hoop.
Take the ball out of bounds. Huh? No, we're taking it out from the side. Yeah, going this way. All right, all we want to see if they match up on us. They do match up on us. Take this man, two-man, go around to the three-point line. The next man, cut this way. This man here, three-man. Get to the free throw, you just get to the free throw. All we got is a pass and catch and shoot. All right, you understand?
Yeah.
All right, and if they don't match up on us, all right, we just do regular stat. All right?
Guys.
1, 2, 3.
Well, Dylan, what sort of deal they gonna run out?
Again, very deliberate. You're probably gonna look to see Brooke Rusko start in a line-out format, which we're so familiar in this country with rugby. Brooke Rusko is going to wrap around everybody and try and get to the hoop down the other end and try and make a long pass to him.
Richie Edwards launches it from half court. And it goes in. Can you believe it?
I'll tell you what, this crowd would have absolutely erupted if that had gone down.
Unbelievable. Can you believe the scenes here at the North Shore Event Center in Auckland, New Zealand? The untested Junior Tall Blacks, 35, Argentina, 31.
Competition, and you'll see performances right through the tournament.
Please would you welcome the Kelston girls. Bring it on.
Ladies and gentlemen, to the North Shore Event Center here in Auckland, New Zealand, where the Junior Tall Blacks here, 35, over Argentina, 31. It is halftime. And geez, June 18th, 1932, there were 8 original founding members of FIBA, Argentina being one of them. And if we look at the way things rolled here, 1979, they came in third, 1983, seventh, 1991, third, 95, sixth, 99, fourth, 2003, 10th, 2007, they came in sixth. So they have been at the elite level here, and here are the stats for the first half. And it's got Junior Tall Blacks all over it, doesn't it, Dylan?
Absolutely. The shooting percentage of the Junior Tall Blacks is what jumps out most. 62%, great job, as opposed to 34%. A little bit concerned, though, is the rebounding. 22 rebounds to 13, and 13 of those being offensive rebounds. Again, we talked about how small the tall Junior Tall Blacks team was. It's important now in the second half that they lock down defensively, take care of every loose rebound before they go down the other end.
Yeah, well, we got Brooke Rusko with 12 points and Lowe with 10 points. And, well, we've got Nosa Dow with 10 points for Argentina. But look at this. This was fantastic. Rob Lowe with the first 2 points ever in a FIBA competition for the Junior Tall Blacks. A massive two-handed set down. Richie Edwards, look at this athletic move. Wow, that was just impressive, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
And well, the first half basically was all Junior Tall Blacks, but yes, Argentina did find their way in on a few occasions. There's a few glitches that Kenny McFadden has to go over for the second half. Offensive rebounds, I do believe sometimes it was just the bounce of the ball in the first half there. Argentina getting a multitude of offensive rebounds in that first half. But regardless of that, Junior Tall Blacks are on top here, 35-31.
Yeah, that'll take a lot of confidence out of this first half and, you know, come out with confidence in the second. Let's just hope they can sustain the defensive pressure and the great offensive execution that they've been doing out there.
Now, if the Junior Tall Blacks pull off the inconceivable here against Argentina, where would you put that in Kiwi wins as far as sports goes?
Oh, absolutely. You know, this is knocking off one of the powerhouses in basketball. These guys won the FIBA America's tournament. They beat the USA, they beat Puerto Rico, they beat Canada. So this result is a fantastic, but it is only a stepping stone. Let's not forget that. This is just one game in the pool. We're not going to get too excited too early, but nevertheless, it's going to be a great result if they can sustain this pressure and come away with a win tonight.
Yep, and out of all the games we've seen here today, right from the get-go, these guys were playing some hoops with a few turnovers. The second half is right around the corner, ladies and gentlemen. You stick and stay, don't go away. We'll see you shortly. Argentina 31, New Zealand 35.
I'm too.
welcome back, good people. Lieutenant Dan Hennessy once again alongside Dylan Boucher. And we have just been privy to a fantastic half of basketball here. It started out fast and furious and hasn't slowed down since.
Oh, it's been a great start for the Junior Tall Blacks. It started with the Haka, followed up closely by the Rob Lowe dunk. You know what, these guys are feeling good right now. Their confidence is high. Let's hope this, you know, this break at halftime hasn't sort of taken a little bit, made them cold.
And I'll tell you what, Argentina, they are just, they're walking with their shoulders down. If, you know, they don't have the mojo they had when they first came out here, was clapping to the crowd, dancing around. They thought this was a total walkover tonight.
Yeah, I truly believe they thought they were going to win this comfortably. And, you know, there still is a half to go, mind you.
Yes.
But you're right, the body language out there is definitely in favor of the Junior Tall Blacks. They're running hard into their layups. The Argentinian team, well, they, like you say, the shoulders are forward. They don't look confident out there.
Well, here's how the scorers are going down. Nocidel with 10, Rusko with 12, Ramirez Barrios with 7, Rob Lowe with 10 points there, but a great spread of scoring, and it's great to see the Young Bucks coming up trumps early.
It's a great job by the Junior Tall Blacks. Rusko and Lowe having outstanding games for the first half. They have to do a little bit better job on Nocidel's penetration. He's really getting into the lane,
yep.
Really hurting the Tall Blacks.
Now, if you were the coach of Argentina, Dylan, what would you say to them at halftime to kind of turn their game around?
I think the big thing with the coach probably would have said to them is you know, let's get the nerves away. We've got this one half out of the way. All the nerves should be gone now. We're all comfortable out there. Let's just get out there and play the basketball we know we're capable of and we know that we've had success with. So expect them to be a little bit more patient and expect them to turn up the defense. I would imagine they'll come out with some full court pressure on the Junior Tall Blacks, try and force some turnovers early, get some easy buckets. That's always a way to get yourself going. Easy layups, off turnovers, off steals.
And it was very good to see the Junior Tall Blacks, how composed they were early. They were taking very high percentage shots and sinking them. So it's all going that, they're all going their way at the moment.
The second half has to be no different. They have to pound it inside, get Rob Lowe some open looks inside, you know, set the standard early again and open those shots up for Brooke Rusko. Guys like himself, get some open shots, open threes, break this game open.
Logan Van Beek, the really only Junior Tall Black in foul trouble with 3. But a good, clean game nonetheless, very physical. And well,
I think Logan Van Beek's going to be a key for this Tall Black team. He sets the standard defensively for them. He's an up-and-in player. He's probably one of those guys that you hate playing against because he's always up full court pressuring you, making it hard. And that's exactly what the Junior Tall Blacks need from him.
And yes, well, the Junior Tall Blacks are walking with a little swagger now. The second half is just about upon us. Don't forget, for the next 11 days, we're going to be doing this all day long here on Sky Sports.
It's a Hooper's dream.
Now, if you're Kenny McFadden, what do you say to your Junior Tall Blacks to keep their mojo going?
I think you have to be very careful. You have to keep them composed. You know, it is only a half of basketball, like I said earlier. He wants to keep them composed, keep more of the same thing. Defense is going to set the standard early. He'll be talking a lot about defense, and you again, he'll be very, very, very exact on what he wants out there offensively. I think they need to keep executing their set plays well and doing a good job with that early. Continue that in the second half.
Well, we are a half of basketball, possibly away from New Zealand sporting history here as the Junior Tall Blacks take the court. Once again, the whole world is watching here. We appreciate you joining the broadcast, wherever you might be in the world here. As Mantas Nocidel will inbound here for Argentina. Hernandez will bring it up. Nocidel, he's a bit of a scorer.
Yeah, he knows how to find the hoop, this guy. Here he is, wide open. Not what the Junior Tall Blacks wanted first up.
Gets his own rebound as well. Pops it back up. No go. Dion Prewster will get the tip from low.
A little bit fortunate there, the Junior Tall Blacks.
Very fortunate. Dion Prewster. Richie Edwards goes to penetrate. Runs into Hernandez, and we've got a foul there.
Kenny McFadden will not be happy with that.
Foul is called on 5. Richie
starting the second half, it's important just to run the offense, let the offense work, get an open shot from the offense. Again, I think Richie Edwards is just falling a little bit into the trap of he's trying to be a leader. He's trying to fire his boys up and do some things that he's probably, right now, he doesn't need to do that.
Orlietti with it, top of the key now. Hernandez, unmarked, down low, and one for Andreas Landoni. He's only got 1 point so far in this game. He's supposed to be the next big thing. Well, he just got two more, and potentially another one coming right there.
Again, Kenny McFadden will not be happy. There was a switch in the play, wasn't talked, wasn't communicated, ended up picking up a foul and the basket. Worst possible result.
Landoni, chance to convert the three-point play here, and it will count. As we had a lane violation there, now the Junior Tall Blacks will bring it up.
There's a full court pressure we expected.
Good to get it out of there, Logan Van Beek with it.
Logan with a cool head, he just wants to get it inside to Rob Lowe. Again, we talked about getting it inside to Rob, setting the standard early.
Deion Pooster for three, off the back of the rim, but now the offensive rebounds are going our way. Unfortunately, Deion Pooster could not handle the jandle there.
Great chase down by Pooster. Again, followed his own shot up, got the rebound, unfortunately just lost the handle of the ball.
Argentina will bring it up now. No Sedell with it on the wing.
Back into their zone defense that they had a lot of success with in the first half. Again, Argentina not looking comfortable.
Fernandez with it, five on the shot clock here. Puts up a three, does not go, low with the rebound.
Again, forcing Argentina to take outside shots is exactly what you want.
Logan Van Beek, nice work into Richie Edwards. Shot good. Richie Edwards, he is an athlete.
He made hard work of that. He had a little slip on the floor, but balanced himself, composed himself to put it in. Great pick and roll. They're getting a lot out of that. The screen and roll to the hoop. You saw Rob Lowe get some points off it. Now Richie Edwards doing a great job with that right now. The guards are feeding the bigs very well.
Orlietti with it on the wing. Pooster right in his back pocket. He'll get the ball back. Thought about the shot baseline.
2 seconds.
Goes to penetrate. Shot no good. And Deion Pooster ripped down the rebound. He's hassled by two of them. And he will bring it up over half court.
Another great defensive possession.
Look at this, Deion Pooster. Unbelievable shot. Beautiful.
Great hang time by Pooster. Just hung in the air, waited for the guy to go down, elevated over him, kissed it off the glass.
No Sedell, Orlietti. Hernandez. Hernandez will get the ball back. He will penetrate, kick it out to No Sedell. He is the scorer of Argentina. Hernandez puts it up, and he will miss. Edwards will scoop up that rebound.
Another outstanding defensive position. Twice now, they've brought Argentina right back down into the shot clock.
Richie Edwards, coast to coast! And there's a timeout called by Argentina because they can't believe what's happening to them right now.
Oh, they're feeling good. All the bumps are going on. They're getting the crowd into it. They feel good right now.
Fantastic.
The defense has been outstanding again, getting the shot clock right down to 2 seconds, two possessions in a row, forcing two bad shots. Exactly what Kenny McFadden be wanting out there. Richie Edwards, coast to coast, great move.
Let's go 13. Next play, we go 34. You understand? This play, 13. Look for the quick trap, and we get a call to half court. And then the second play down, we go 34. We keep mixing it back and forth. Our display right now, we go 13. All right, then we go into four defense. But when on the second time they come down, we go back in 34. All right? Hey, defense, make a loud. One, two, three, defense!
Well, what did you get from Coach Kenny McFadden out of that timeout, Dylan?
Again, he's very deliberate in what he wants, which is, you know, with young players, that's exactly what you need to do. You need to give them strict instructions of what he wants out there. Again, he's going to be most happy with the defense, and he's talking about 34s and 24s, which I assume he's talking about what sort of defense they're in.
Yep.
And he's getting a lot of success out of changing his defenses up, and he wants just more of the same.
And geez Louise, I'll tell you, Enrique Tolchier, the head coach of Argentina, did not look all that happy during that last timeout.
Van Beek doing a great job here, getting his troops in the right defense.
Fernandez tries to get into Orlietti, does so, catches low in the air, pops it up, no good. Who's got the rebound? It will go to Nosedell, and we've got a foul on Richie Edwards.
Great job by Lowe, flicking that ball out. The guards have to pick that up. Rob's doing an extremely good job in there, flicking the ball out. The guards need to swoop up on that ball before they run down on offense. I think we're getting a little ahead of ourselves. Brooke Rusko probably guilty there of trying to break for a layup. Probably should have gone for the ball.
All right, Gonzalez to inbound here. Argentina. Landoni back to Gonzalez. He has it. Nosedell. Gonzalez. Around the horn it goes. Fernandez. Back to Gonzalez. Out to Fernandez. Goes to penetrate. Does so. Nice pass inside. Look at this. They've got seven left on the shot clock, but every time Argentina tries to get the ball down low, they are just denied by the junior Tall Blacks.
Deion Prewster is, that could be his second or third block of the game. He's doing an outstanding job.
He's only 6 foot four.
Absolutely. Very athletic.
Nosedell tries to take matters into his own hand. We'll get the shot off. They'll get another offensive rebound. Gonzalez will put it back and in.
That hurts again. They force him into a tough shot. 1 second on the shot clock. Shot clock expires. They get an offensive rebound and a putback. That really hurts.
All right, Deion Prewster brings it back for the junior Tall Blacks. Richie Edwards behind the back. Beautiful moves from him. Look at this. He will draw a foul on Andreas Landoni. And that's what I think him and Prewster have to do a lot, is keep on penetrating and drawing fouls on Argentina's bigs.
Absolutely. Richie Edwards has done a better job the second half of decision-making, choosing when he likes to penetrate. Every time he penetrates, he's getting good stuff out of it. He's just got to pick and choose his moments. Same with Prewster. You know, these guys are fantastic penetrators, and they need to attack, keep attacking the Argentinians.
He will miss the free throw here. With the two-pointers, the New Zealand junior Tall Blacks shooting 67%, and Argentina's shooting a woeful 32%.
Absolutely, that's a testament to the junior Tall Blacks defense. They forced them to take either contested shots at the end of the shot clock, or long three-pointers, and that's paying dividends for them right now.
Yeah, Richie Edwards could not convert on the free throws. So Fernandez now has the rock for Argentina. Gonzalez in the corner goes to Nosedell. He puts
great
it up.
Block.
Oh man, blocked again.
Numbers now.
Could have been a foul there. Rusko with it. And look, he will get called with a travel on the way down.
He got caught in a little bit of indecision there. Great defense by the Argentinians. Forced him to pick up his dribble early and take too many steps.
Morgan Nathan into the game for Richie Edwards. And Glenberg is into the game for Andreas Landoni, who's only sitting on 4 points. Allegedly now, Argentina's next big thing.
Yeah, absolutely. This guy plays professional basketball in Spain. Landoni, they're expecting big things from him in this tournament. Junior Tall Blacks doing a great job again defensively in that zone.
Fernandez pops one up, no good. Deion Prewster rips down that rebound. He plays like he's 6 foot nine, but he's only 6 foot four, is Deion Prewster.
Mismatch on the wing here. Great job. Oh.
Clearing out foul down low.
That, to me, that's a great job by Rob Lowe. He's doing exactly what a big man's supposed to do. A little bit unlucky from the referee there.
Offensive foul is called on number 15, Rob Lowe.
Yeah, he has to be really hard done by there by that. Great job, Rob.
Spoken like a true player.
Absolutely, absolutely. He'll be disappointed to pick up that foul, and I'm sure Kenny Mack will be exactly the same.
Fernandez now over to Nosedell. Mantis has it back over to Juan Fernandez. A little bit of tennis action here with Nosedell getting it back, tries to drive. In the corner it goes to Gonzalez. It will drop for him, and that'll be a three from the baseline, and they needed that bad.
One of the few open looks they've had, and they've knocked it down. The junior Tall Blacks need to understand that when the baseline penetration happens, there's always a guy sitting in the corner.
And Morgan Nathan, that was a silly foul there, as all of a sudden the wheels are beginning to fall off the junior Tall Blacks wagon. Still up by two, however.
And a mistake. Back-to-back mistakes. You know, the Argentinians, if they make them pay on this possession, that will really hurt the junior Tall Blacks.
Gonzalez will find Fernandez here. 4:40 left to go in the third. Nosedell.
Running place for Nosedell now. He's the hot guy.
There's Deion Prewster with a hand in the passing lane. He'll steal it. Nice pass. Up it goes. How did that not go in? Who's got the ball?
Great job, Morgan Nathan.
Morgan Nathan, look at this. Somehow Fernandez will end up with it. Find Gonzalez. He'll put up a three-pointer, and that'll go off the back of the iron. And, well, they'll get the rebound.
Great defense.
They'll put it up again. How much time can they spend down in that paint? 2 points for Enrico Glinberg.
Tight ball game now. Junior Tallbacks will not be happy. Again, offensive rebounds hurting them. This layup, that really hurts them as well.
And we are all knotted up at 41, ladies and gentlemen. Morgan Nathan with the top of the key. Finds Brooke Rusko. He was very hot the first half as he goes to penetrate. And we get a foul. Fantastic work by Rob Lowe.
I think they would have talked about Rob Lowe at halftime. He nailed a few jumpers in the first half. The coach obviously wants the players to get up on him. Nice little fake by Rob. Drew the foul.
David Beck back into the game for Brooke Rusko. Going with a little bit more size here are the junior tall blacks. And Dion Prewster will inbound here. Fresh 24 for the JTBs. Lowe with it. Thinks about going baseline.
I like the aggressiveness of Rob Lowe. He's really looking to take it to these Argentinians.
And why wouldn't you? Because every time he does, he seems to ping one of them with a foul.
Absolutely. Good results are coming from his penetration right now.
Because at the end of the game, all the free throws at the line are gold. And he impresses me, just Rob Lowe.
He's playing extremely well.
Dion Prewster, set piece coming up here for the junior tall blacks. Morgan Nathan. Beck sets a screen, back to Lowe. Lowe penetrates. Look at this! Can you believe this kid? Where did he come from?
He is playing out of his skin right now. Again, running out on his jump shot, up fake, penetration, and throws it down with authority and the yell afterwards. I love it.
I love it.
And the steal.
And the steal. Can this kid do it all or what? And look at this. Josh Bloxham will somehow track it down with 20 seconds left of the shot clock. And another foul here on Argentina, number 11, Fabian Barrios.
Rob Lowe is doing it all right now. Great composure by Josh Bloxham to slow it down.
Check this out. They didn't see this coming at all. Whack.
Rob would have all his family here watching, spurring him on.
Oh, being they're loving it.
Being a local boy.
The Australian team sitting behind us, they're loving it. Lowe with it.
I don't know about that, Dan.
Morgan Nathan, look at that. He'll draw another foul. Here we go. Penetrate, penetrate, penetrate. Draw the fouls.
The penetration's really hurting this Argentinian team. They're not doing a great job of getting across. The junior tall blacks are doing a fantastic job in getting to the front of the rim, either drawing the foul or getting something good out of the penetration.
And this just goes to show, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't have size, you go with the speed. And the junior tall blacks with a collapsing defense here.
I like the look of this Morgan Nathan. He's done some good things tonight. He looks like a good athlete. He's a player we want to see more in the future.
6'5", born in Queenstown, New Zealand, Morgan Nathan.
Again, full court pressure from the junior tall blacks. Beck's caught in a bit of a mismatch here. They managed to sort it back out. Again, in that zone defense.
Cortez with it, inside it goes to Glinberg, back out to no good there for Gonzalez.
Another wide open look for Gonzalez. It's not good for the junior tall blacks. They need to cover that corner spot.
Dion Prewster now. Good ball control from him. Finds Lowe.
Nice.
Look at that into Beck. Beautiful.
That is textbook basketball at its finest. Come off the on-ball screen, hit the big high, hit the guy rolling to the hoop. That's just fun to watch.
And while Puerto Rico beating Lithuania today, that might have put a ripple through the basketball community worldwide, but this will be a tidal wave, ladies and gentlemen, if the junior tall blast can pull this game off.
No one would be picking this result right now.
And there is a three-pointer from Frederico Fernandez. That's going to sting a little bit there. 3 points in it. Dion Prewster with the rock. Beck sets the screen. Over to Lowe. Inside it goes to Beck. Another nice pass into David Beck. Couldn't convert.
Again, that's exactly what they want to do. They want to get it inside to the bigs. Beck doing a great job in there. He just has to convert those little sitters inside there.
Fernandez, high off the glass, no good. Glinberg knocks it out of bounds, but somehow gets it back.
again, I'm harping on about it, I know, but the offensive rebounding and the corner shooters are really hurting the junior Tall Blacks right now. Something Kenny McFadden needs to address.
Fernandez with a three-point attempt from the other baseline side. No good. Here comes Deion Prewster. Momentarily lost the rock. Got it back. Morgan Nathan has it now. 12 on the shot clock for the junior Tall Blacks. Lowe.
Rob Lowe thinking about a three-pointer.
Trying to get it into Beck. Not to be, maybe trying to thread the needle a little too finely there.
Yeah, I think Beck's doing a great job trying to seal inside there. Rob Lowe probably a little bit guilty of trying to force the pass in there. But that's exactly what they want to do. They want to pound it inside on Argentina. They've had some success. Keep going at it.
Argentina now. Fernandez.
Again, a guy sitting in the corner here.
Gonzalez.
Cortez.
And Gonzalez is just left alone, and he will take advantage of that. That'll be the easiest 2 points he makes all night. Blocks him.
Starting to see Argentina's penetration coming up. It's really starting to hurt the junior Tall Blacks at the moment.
Morgan Nathan, nice move. Couldn't convert, gets his own rebound. Gets it knocked out of his hand, and that will be a foul on Luciano Gonzalez. Good work down low by Morgan Nathan.
I think Morgan Nathan might have got away with the travel. They let it go, got his own rebound, drew the foul. Great job. Again, I like this kid. I like what he's bringing to the table right now for the junior Tall Blacks. He's bringing energy, and he's getting on the boards. He's playing defense. He's doing it all.
Well, there's your fouls. Glenberg with three, Gonzalez with two. And why the only junior Tall Black with three fouls at the moment is Logan Van Beek. And he will convert that one, Will Morgan Nathan.
3 for 3 so far for Nathan.
Nice form, great form from him.
Beautiful stroke.
49-46, 21 seconds left to go here in the third. The junior Tall Blacks still clinging to the smallest of leads.
Argentina running the clock down. Kenny McFadden pushing the troops back, making them pack the lane in. Gonna see penetration here from Cortez. Yes.
Double dribble called on Christian Cortez. Junior Tall Blacks ball.
Great job by Brooke Rusko getting off him. Closing his penetration and passing lanes down.
Now they get 5.3 seconds here. That's plenty of time to get a decent shot off here at the end of the third. Rusko had the hot hand in the first half, puts up a three. That's off the back of the iron. But look at those junior Tall Blacks just swarm like hornets on that rim.
These guys are hungry. They're going after every rebound. They know how important this first win is.
Look at Rob Lowe down there. He's loving it. Once again, Argentina 46, New Zealand 49. And here are your statistics thus far. Rebounding, Argentina 32, New Zealand 23. Any other stats jumping out at you?
Yeah, I mean, that's a big one. 11 turnovers, still a little bit high. And New Zealand, 6 blocks to 1, that's a fantastic jog. I think Brewster's probably been, you know, the person who's been racking those stats up. But the thing that really sticks out to me is the 62% field goal percentage from inside the arc, as opposed to Argentina, 33%. That is a phenomenal difference in the game. The only thing keeping the Argentinian team in this game right now is rebounding.
That's the only shot they've been making is in these corners. So in penetration on that skip in the corner, it's the forward's job to get out there. So you're only helping until this man get down, and then you can prepare to play the corner. So it's a wing player, or it could be you. Do you understand? Now, once again, we get the ball, look for the breakers, unscreens, re-screens, get into the dribble handoff. Some high lows will work, but not too many in a row. Get a couple of more dribble handoffs, all right?
It's 3 too many. Keep them down. We got this.
Okay, make it loud. 1, 2, 3.
And well, there are the Syrians watching the game. They played earlier on today. Fantastic to see them here, checking everything out. What a marvelous opening ceremony here in Auckland to kick everything off.
Yeah, I tell you, the organizing committee's done a great job of running this tournament. You saw a fantastic opening ceremony. The floor looks amazing. The stadium looks amazing. You know, all the volunteers are doing exactly what they're supposed to be doing. This, I think, You know, FIBA must be extremely happy with the way, you know, New Zealand has hosted this tournament so far.
Even the Right Honourable John Key, the Prime Minister of New Zealand, is here tonight. And the Junior Tall Blacks are definitely not letting him or anyone in the stands here down.
Defense and rebounding is going to be the key for the Junior Tall Blacks to win this game. And turnovers, obviously. Logan Van Beek will not be happy with that.
Richie Edwards will find Logan Van Beek. Is he going to try and make up for it? Yes, he will. Out it goes to Lowe for three. Off the front of the rim, no good. But look at Logan Van Beek down there. The smallest guy on the floor gets the offensive rebound. Oh, and he steps out of bounds. Unfortunately, Argentina's ball.
Logan Van Beek showing how it's done down there. Little man amongst the trees.
Gonzalez has it. Lindbergh, Cortez. Good ball movement for this timeout here by Argentina. Gonzalez for three, and he will nail it right in Richie Edwards' face.
All of a sudden, you've seen the body language change. You know, you've got Gonzalez pumping fists now, getting his boys fired up. Again, the tide seems to have swung a little bit now towards the Argentinians. Defensive pressures come up.
Richie Edwards finds Deion Prewster. Inside it goes to Lowe. Lowe spins. Nice little soft shot. No good. Lindbergh with the rebound. Kick it off to Fernandez.
That's exactly what the Junior Tall Blacks want. They want Rob Lowe, the ball inside. Back to a man-to-man defense now for the Junior Tall Blacks. They feel the zone. Too many open shots in the zone.
51-49. JTB's down by two. Gonzalez puts up a three, and that one rims out. He had all day to line that one up. And look at this, back the other way. And one, no, it will not convert for him, but at the end of the day, there's a foul. Brooke Rusko going to the line.
Brooke Rusko's been very exciting in this game. You know, on the break there, turned the guy inside out, laid it up, got the foul, unlucky to finish to make the end one play.
And again, these free throws are so crucial throughout the game, but especially now, crunch time.
Absolutely.
They'll nail the first.
Both teams not shooting a good clip from the free throw line. Argentina 60%, Tall Blacks 63%.
Brooke Rusko, one of the characters of the Junior Tall Blacks. He will nail them both. Automatic from him, from the line.
Brooke Rusko is actually battling a bit of illness in this game, so it's amazing to have the energy that he's got out there. He's been sick along with Rob Lowe and a few of the others. Judd Flavel, one of the assistant coaches.
Yep.
I've been struck down by a bit of illness, so these guys are, you know, performing extremely well under the circumstances.
Argentina. Cortez. Nice pick off by Deion Prewster. Off to Richie Edwards, and now they're going to slow things down, and that's smart. Again, go back to what worked at the beginning of the game, high percentage shots.
Looking to high post here, looking to cut off Logan Van Beek. On ball screen coming up.
Logan Van Beek into Lowe. Lowe's got a bit of a mismatch there. You should recognize this. Back out to Van Beek for three. Rims out, no good.
That's good basketball. Inside out basketball. Throw it into Rob. Double team, kick out. Logan Van Beek. Good D.
And look at that. Fantastic D. 12 seconds left on the shot clock here for Argentina. They just can't seem to find a way in. There's a nice shot, no good off the rim. Who's got it? Logan Van Beek. Darting around, looking to penetrate. Around it goes to Deion Prewster. In the corner to Rusko. Through the paint. Look at that shot. You've got to be kidding me. How did he change his direction like that?
Brooke Rusko has really impressed me putting the ball on the floor. I thought he was known as a three-point shooter. He surprised me, and he's put the ball on the floor several times with great success and won basketball. That's great.
Wow, what a change of direction in the air from him. Whoop, look at that.
For a little guy, he's fearless.
And the coach is loving it. The coach is feeling it. He's liking it. And well, New Zealand now up by two. Multiple lead changes here.
Number six, Glenberg from the Argentinian team. Not very happy about being subbed out. As is Razio, not very happy either. So some very unhappy Argentinians sitting down in front of us there.
Well, they must be doing something wrong here.
It's not what they're doing wrong, it's what the Junior Tall Blacks are doing right now.
All right, here comes Argentina. Fernandez, no Sedell. Back to Fernandez, nine on the shot clock. No Sedell, long three. Yes.
Ooh. That's what they're forcing them to do, shoot threes. Nosedale has proved he's a good player. To knock down, penetrate, and also knock down the three.
Richie Edwards into Rob Lowe, gets picked off. Here comes Argentina, counterattack in transition.
Good defense, Fernandez.
No Sedell, back to Fernandez. Brewster up on him, across it goes. And that will be called a travel on Andreas Landoni.
Landoni got a little bit ahead of himself. Wanted to go attack Rob Lowe. Rob Lowe, great job defensively.
Josh Bloxham in for Logan Van Beek. Good minutes from him. And there's the coach.
Bloxham checks in.
Enrique Tolchier. He is not impressed with his team at the moment.
Kenny McFadden getting some fresh legs on the court.
Smart move from him. Bloxham. Richie Edwards. Richie Edwards puts up a floater off the front of the rim as Rob Lowe goes flying. It's Argentina once again. And that'll be a foul down low as Andreas Landoni went up for it.
Good foul by Brooke Rusko, making them earn their points. There's a mismatch inside there with Landoni on Rusko. Did a good job fouling him, put him at the line, make him earn his 2 points. Transition defense is going to have to be a key in this fourth quarter.
Smart play by the junior Tall Blacks. Landoni at the line. And the first one, null and void.
Landoni hasn't had a very fruitful night out here. He's 1 for 8 from the field, and I know he's missed a few free throws as well, so he's struggling a little bit right now.
Sitting on 4 points, let's make it 5. Now up by 1 point is Argentina. Richie Edwards, Dion Brewster.
Captain taking control here, getting his troops organized.
10 on the shot clock for the junior Tall Blacks. Low with it, and he is just mugged by Orlietti.
Foul is called on 9.
And look at this, give me a wallet.
Great job by Dion Brewster, organizing his troops, getting them organized, being very deliberate in what they run. This is crucial, 5 minutes to go in the ball game. They have to be very deliberate in what they want to do out there.
Rusko loses the rock, unfortunately. And that's a big turnover here for the junior Tall Blacks.
Turnovers are really hurting the junior Tall Blacks right now. They need to get their composure. Again, execute their offense. They don't need to force anything. Let the offense do the work for them.
Down by 1 point, even though Argentina has 21 offensive rebounds to New Zealand's 6. Down by 1 point.
I must say, the zone defense has really caused the Argentinian team problems. Again, another turnover.
Hey, fantastic. And almost another turnover going back the other way. No Sedell had his hands in the passing lane there. Dion Brewster will bring it up and skate away from him. Rob Lowe, open for the three, decides to penetrate. Brooke Rusko for three.
Bang! Again, perfectly executed offense. That's exactly what they would have wanted. Come down, execute well. Great result, Brooke Rusko knocking down another three.
Junior Tall Blacks are probably one of the better polished teams I've seen here today.
They're definitely executing well. Kenny McFadden's done a great job in the last month or so with the troops.
Good ball movement this time around. No Sedell leaves his hand in the air. We all know what that means as he sinks a three.
No Sedell is really starting to be a thorn in the junior Tall Blacks side right now. He's really hurting him with the shooting and his penetration.
15 points for him at the moment. Dion Brewster with the rock now.
Very impressed with Brewster's maturity.
Richie Edwards. Low, goes to penetrate. Off the glass, no good. Edwards tried a big putback. Didn't work for him. No Sedell on the run. And it's looking down from Dion Brewster.
Brewster,
he's got 4 blocks today. Rusko back the other way. And he will be fouled on the way in.
What a whole lot of events going on here. We've got a block shot down one end, fast break basketball down the other end. Brooke Rusko going to the line for 2 free throws.
And there's Pedro Cameron, another one of the Southern Hemisphere's best kept secrets. Tall Black, he's loving to see what these young guys are doing.
I'll tell you what, there'll be no one more prouder than Piero down there, along with Nenad Vucinic.
Rusko at the line, will sink the first. And with 4 minutes left, ladies and gentlemen, we are all knotted up at 58 apiece.
Rusko has been playing outstanding. 21 points in the ball game, one free throw to come.
Let's make that 22, shall we?
Rusko makes both.
This kid can stroke the ball. Outstanding shooting from Brook today.
Fantastic ball skills from him now. Here comes Argentina looking to answer back. Token. New Zealand up by one.
Token extended pressure from the junior tallbacks. Bloxham doing a good job. Just being a little bit disruptive up the court.
No Sadal with it. 10 on the shot clock. Again, they are running behind schedule. He puts up another three, leaves his hands in the air, and he'll nail another one.
They cannot leave Nosedal open. He is hot right now.
Blocks him with it.
Although they're in a zone, they need to be a little bit closer to Nosedal, getting a hand up on that shot.
Richie Edwards. Thought about the three. Get it to the man with the hot hand, Rusko. He penetrates, puts it up, takes them all on. There's Rob Lowe for the putter.
Rob Lowe, great job. Brooke Rusko, fearless, going to the hoop.
61 apiece, just over 3 minutes left to go.
Where's Nosedal? They've got to find him. He's in the far corner.
Orlietti can't see him. Hernandez goes, almost gets his pocket picked. And look at that, beautiful move by Fabian Barrios. We'll get two off the glass.
Tough putback.
2 points in it, Junior Tallblacks with the rock. Deion Brewster has it.
Slowing it down.
Rusko to Edwards. Edwards on the wing.
They want to get the ball in Rusko's hands, coming off the handoff.
Low with it, looking for somewhere to pass it, and they will get it back somehow. He's getting it off. 1 second, he puts it up. That's off the front of the rim. They did get it off in time. But to no avail, here comes Argentina.
Good heads-up play, though. Rusko getting the shot off before the shot clock expires.
Mike Fernandez with the inside. It goes to Orlietti, and another pickoff down there low by Deion Brewster. He's doing it all at the moment.
Brewster is leading from the front. That's what you want your captain to do.
He's got multiple steals. He's got four blocks. Yikes. Stuffing the stat sheet is Deion Brewster.
They need to keep executing.
2 minutes left of the ball game. Junior Tallblacks looking to tie it up. Somehow it does not go down for Deion Brewster.
Very unlucky. Great move. Just couldn't quite finish.
And here's Nosedal. Keep an eye on him. He'll be floating around the three-point line like he has been all game, stinging the Junior Tallblacks from afar.
Deion Brewster looking a little tired out there. Rob Lowe bumping bodies inside. Good to see the big man taking care of the keyhole.
Oh, he's got some mongrel in him. He certainly does.
Nosedal.
2 seconds left. 1 second. Oh, man. Nosedal is just playing like a man possessed.
This kid is on fire. He is doing everything for this team. He's single-handedly brought Argentina back into this game, taking the lead, four-point buffer right now.
He's so happy, he's mad, if that makes any sense.
Absolutely, he's punching his teammates, he's pushing people, he's fired up. He's trying to get his teammates to get on the same level that he's on right now. Important timeout for the Junior Tall Blacks. Kenny McFadden, what's he got to say?
I deny this. I think we can set him up. If we get the ball on the next couple possessions out of defense, we go break us to the dribble handoff. I want it all the way through the dribble handoff. If not, we look at hand. All right? We look at hand. But this particular play here, all right, I want 10. All right, we understand? I want 10 coming down. All right, you understand? Yeah, press release. Press release. All right, let's go. Hey, defense is going to win it. 1, 2, 3.
Defense. Mr. Boucher, what did you get out of that timeout from Coach Kenny McFadden?
If you're wondering what all the chins and the breaker, these are just names of plays that they want to run through. They want to run a chin set, which I think is the X-ing off the high post. Seeing Rob Lowe step out. I believe the breaker is where they go, the dribble handoff. Look for Rusko or Brewster to come off the dribble handoff. So right now, I think we're going to see an X-ing through the high post.
All right, crunch time here for the Junior Tallblacks. Lowe with it. As Richie Edwards inbounded, Logan Van Beek now, 20 seconds left on the shot clock. Plenty of time here to get a decent look for the Junior Tallblacks. We get a foul underneath on Orlietti. He nails another one.
Rob Lowe is really causing trouble for these guys. They're trying to push him. They're trying to do everything they can to upset him. He's staying composed. See what he's got from the free throw line.
And these are big shots from the youngster.
He has got every role in this building tonight.
Yeah, get that man some chicken, because he's got all the roles here tonight, let me tell you. Except for that one, unfortunately. Down by three, Argentina with the ball.
Important defensive position here from the Junior Tall Blacks. Van Beek brought in for his defensive pressure. Again, sticking with that zone defense. It's worked for them all game.
And no Saddell's out there again at three-point line. He thought about it, then went to penetrate. Inside it goes,
great,
and look at that
deep
work!
Great
beautiful
steal
work!
Numbers.
3 points in it now. Richie Edwards brings it up.
Edwards slows it up.
Less than a minute to go. Logan Van Beek.
Looking to run the breakers set here.
Are they going to go for a three, or do they want the two? Low with it, loses the handle. Oh, no, goes down. It gets up slowly. And that is not a good sight for the Junior Tall Blacks.
Absolutely not. It's hurting right now.
He landed awkwardly, did Rob Lowe.
He's still managing to bump in the inside, which is good to see. Fight it out, Rob. They need a stop right here. They need it.
5 seconds left in the shot clock.
Argentina using up all the clock. Great defense. Great defense.
And that will do it. And we've got a foul called.
Two free throws to come.
Two free throws to come with 17.3 seconds left to go.
These will quite confidently be Logan Van Beek's most important free throws of his career to date.
That is an awkward landing there by Rob Lowe. We just sort of see what happened there. He's going to come off, and that is most unfortunate.
That is not good at this stage of the game. That's a big man falling down, too.
Well, we're hoping he could just get some ice on it, but the way that he landed there, it doesn't look promising for Rob Lowe. It looks like his ankle.
Logan Van Beek, a very good free throw shooter. Again, I don't want to put the commentator's curse on him, but he is an extremely good free throw shooter, confident.
This could make it a one-point ball game. And there you have it. 1 point in it.
1 point in it. They're going to need to get a stop here, or they're going to have to foul. This is where the coaches earn their money.
Yep.
Important timeout. They're going to be looking who is the worst free throw shooter on this Argentinian team if they are going to foul. Or they're going to be looking to get a steal and not let the clock get down too low.
Now, Rob Lowe immediately getting some ice put on that ankle.
It's not looking good. He's obviously not going to finish out this game with the ice on the ankle. A huge blow for the Junior Tall Blacks.
They got it at half court. All right. What we're going to have to do, if they get it at half court right here, we're going to have to match up into a five defense. Five defense. They're going to try to delay the ball. If we see any good trap, yeah, half court.
And manning the ball from half court.
Yeah. So we're going to have to look for a good trap here, and we're going to have to go for a gamble. Press on the ball. And you press the ball, and you go for the trap.
All right. Switch to the screens.
No. All right, let's go. Five defense. Five, just five command.
All right, 17.3 seconds left to go in this competition. 1 point in it. And regardless of the outcome, the Junior Tall Blacks here have definitely put New Zealand basketball back on the world map.
You're not lying about that, Dan. This has been a fantastic game. It would be great to see a victory from the Junior Tall Blacks. Either way this game pans out, they can take a moral victory either way.
Absolutely. Playing fantastically.
Now they want to force a turnover here or force the players into a trapping area. Try and get a violation in the backcourt. Here's an opportunity to trap.
And we've got a foul called on Dion Prewster.
It's fine. There's nothing wrong with that.
11.8 seconds left to go.
They are not in the bonus, so they will not shoot free throws right now. They have to foul three more times
to put
Argentina on the line. So they've got three fouls to give.
Smart foul from Dion Prewster.
Absolutely. They cannot let too much time run off this clock. That's most important right now. They need to be physical, not let the Argentinians get anything here.
Gonzalez to inbound. Finds no Saddell, and they will foul him immediately.
1 second gone off the clock. It's a good foul.
Yep.
Still two more fouls before they force Argentina to shoot free throws.
And again, a very well-disciplined team, as none of the junior Tall Blacks are really in any foul trouble. Gonzalez will do it all over again to inbound. Finds Orlietti.
Oh.
Back to Gonzalez, and he's fouled by Logan Van Beek.
Very close to getting a steal there.
Orlietti, I would have fouled him right off the bat. He doesn't strike me as the best free throw shooter here. Let's not forget, they're only shooting 57% from the free throw line. Gonzalez to inbound one more time. 7.8 seconds left to go.
Next foul is shooting.
Next one sets up to the line.
Oh, turnover!
Can you believe what's happening here? Every game traveled!
No!
No! Oh, the humanity of it all!
We'll see it on the replay here. Oh, he definitely traveled. He definitely did travel. Unfortunately, that is very, very unfortunate. Morgan Nathan's had an outstanding game. Logan Van Beek with the steal, coming down. Unfortunate traveling violation.
They could have come down there with 3.3 seconds left in the game and taken it.
It's one of those situations, Dan, where, you know, if that was early on in the game, the referees would have let it go.
If you can't get a hand on the ball, you got to get a quick foul. You understand? A quick foul, all right? But it's the all over the ball. Foul, how you feeling? Your ankle's out? We got a timeout here. We got a timeout, all right? We got one more. We got, no, we can't. So what happens is, try to get a deflection on the ball. All right, whoever catch it, if he ain't got the steal, quick foul. All right, let's go. Hey, defense can win it. Defense, one, two, three.
Defense!
Well, 3.9 seconds left to go. Is there enough time for the JTBs?
3.9 seconds of basketball is a long time, Dan. These junior Tall Blacks, they can get a hand on the ball. Richie Edwards gets a hand on the ball here. Anything can happen. If they do not get a steal or a deflection straight away, they must foul. They can't let more than 1 second go off this clock. Otherwise, it's going to make it very hard down the other end.
Just 1 point in it. And we've got a foul by Dion Prewster. 2.1 seconds left to go.
Foul is called on 13, Dion Prewster.
A lot of pressure now.
Absolutely.
Cortez to the line, two free throws.
Timeout will be called before Christian Cortez can go to the line, so he's got a few more minutes to think about it.
Kenny McFadden calling the timeout. A lot of times coaches do this to put the hex on the shooter, make him have a whole timeout thinking about making the two free throws. Also, Kenny McFadden will be wanting to talk to his troops about it when the shot's made or missed, what they're going to do, what play they're going to run.
Unbelievable scenes here, ladies and gentlemen, from the North Shore Event Center in Auckland, New Zealand.
We get it out, all right? Understand this. We got no more timeouts. All right? What we're going to have to do, all right? We, listen, sideline press break that we've been working on. Sideline press break. So what happens is from there, let's just make sure that we got Dion playing in this spot right here. Logan in this spot. Brooke, you're going to be boxing out the shooter. So when you take the ball out of bounds, we got the sideline, all right? You got that? Sideline press break. Defense, one, two, three, defense.
Well, the junior Tall Blacks really making some noise here.
I would not be surprised if Cortez makes this first free throw to see him deliberately miss the second free throw. As soon as the ball hits the rim, the clock is activated. Now, we saw in the New Zealand NBL final, you know, we had a classic case there of the clock starting as the ball hits the rim.
These are huge shots for Christian Cortez. And the first one is money.
Let's see what he does on the second now.
He does miss it on there purpose. Junior Tall Blacks, I've got to get the rock. They tried to call a timeout there, but the referees say that's the end of the game. What's going on here? There was 0.8 seconds left to go in the game. The referees have called it. Somehow, Argentina has squeaked out of the North Shore Event Center with just a two-point win over the junior Tall Blacks.
Crazy end to this game. Again, the clock stopped with 0.8 seconds. The referee determined the game was over. He's called the game again. They missed the free throw on purpose, got the perfect result. The ball was fumbled. The time ran out. It was a great miss. You don't often say that in basketball, but it was a smart miss, and it ran the time off the clock, didn't allow the junior Tall Blacks to get a shot off.
And at the end of the day, the Junior Tall Blacks have really asserted themselves here, belonging in this tournament. We just hope that Rob Lowe's going to be okay with that ankle.
Physios will be working overtime.
And your winners, Argentina.
They can hold their heads high, though. They played outstandingly well.
Absolutely. Swarming, hornet-like defense. And here's the stats. Fantastic stuff here. And look at that, blocks 7-1. And Dion Prewster had his fingerprints over most of them.
He sure did.
But 21 offensive rebounds to Argentina and only 8 to New Zealand. That's gonna be rectified for the next game.
Yeah, it's something that they'll be addressing, you know, probably tomorrow in a meeting, or even tonight in a meeting when they get home. You know, Judd Flavel's probably gonna be the guy who's been hard on the stats. He's gonna be talking about boxing out, doing the hard work underneath, getting the easy rebounds, and then attacking down the other end.
And well, here are the highlights. Unbelievable scenes here. Richie Edwards, a fantastic move from him. And the Junior Tall Blacks took about a 6-point lead there halfway through the second half. As you see, there was no answer down low. Argentina didn't have an answer, and then all of a sudden their shooters started to warm up a little bit from those corners in the outside.
I tell you what, Argentina has a lot to thank Nasser Dao. What an outstanding game. He single-handedly brought this game back and single-handedly won this game, I believe, for Argentina.
No Sedell with 21 points, Ramirez Barrios with 9 points, for the Junior Tall Blacks, Brooke Rusko with 22 points. Rob Lowe, the young buck, with 15, played fantastically. Really, it was one of the more polished games we've seen here today, in day one of the FIBA Under 19 World Championships.
It sure has, Dan. It just shows what preparation these Tall Blacks have been in. You know, Kenny McFadden's had them for over a month now. They've been in camp together, they've lived together, they've done everything together, and it shows on the floor tonight. They played well as a team and executed well, which, like you said, they're probably one of the most polished offensive teams out here.
And once again, the qualification path for the 2009 FIBA Under 19 World Championships for Argentina. In 2008, they were the FIBA Americas Under 18 gold medalists. They beat the United States. They just squeaked out a 2-point victory over a team that has never been in this competition before. Wow!
They can hold their head high, Dan, for sure. A crucial traveling violation, unlucky for Morgan Nathan. He's gonna be feeling for it right now.
And right there's the end of the game. Although there was about a second left on there, Kenny McFadden thought there was time. But this is the end, ladies and gentlemen. Argentina 66 and the Junior Tall Blacks 64. All right, we're gonna head down to interview sidelines. What you got happening down there, my man?
Juan Fernandez, a very, very close game. Did you expect such a tough competition from New Zealand?
Yeah, we came to the game prepared to play like this. We knew that it was going to be tough because the home team, there was a lot of crowd cheering for them, so it's a plus always for every team. But, you know, we just came here to do our game. Maybe the basket was close at the beginning, and the zone maybe complicated us a little bit. But, you know, it's always good to start winning, so it's a victory that we take.
What do you put your win down to?
Sorry?
What do you put the win down to?
I don't understand.
How did you win the game, do you think?
Oh. Well, I think we scored 3-pointers in the second half. You know, that's the only way to break the zone. And, you know, our defense wasn't the one we want to do in the tournament. So, you know, there's a lot of things to get better after this game, so you know, now we gotta start thinking in tomorrow and try to make the things we did bad better, you know.
Tough schedule. Good luck for the rest of the tournament, Juan.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, well, No Sedell with 21 points. Brooke Rusko, top scorer of the game with 22 points. But Dion Prewster with 3 blocks, just fantastic. Let's rock back down to Andrew Mulligan. He's got Dion on ice.
Dion Prewster, captain of the Junior Tall Blacks. That is a tough loss, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very tough to take a loss like that at the very end. And, you know, we didn't execute our plays and stuff like that. So against a quality team like that, we can't afford to do that.
You mixed up your defense a little bit in the second half, but the zone killed you. Do you expect that from the Argentinians with their shooting?
Yeah, you know, they're a great three-point shooting team. And, you know, we try to play zone and mix it up a little bit, but, you know, they just have such a poised team under pressure, and they just, you know, killed us when we made mistakes and punished us.
You think you surprised a lot of people today, though?
Yeah, I think a lot of people didn't think we were going to do much, and we know within ourselves that we can play at this level, and, you know, tomorrow we just have to bounce back from this and just go back to the drawing board.
Self-belief is so important in tournaments like these. You've got a tough game tomorrow. Are you ready for that one now?
Yeah, definitely. You know, we have to forget about this game. You know, although it's a very tough situation that we're in, to only lose by two, but we have Croatia tomorrow, and they're another strong side. So we have to think about the next game.
All right, Dion. Good luck.
Thanks. Well, there you have it. Argentina 66, New Zealand 64. We have 11 days of glorious basketball left here at the FIBA World Under-19 Men Championships here in Auckland, New Zealand. Until the next time we meet, I hope you're hitting nothing but net. Good night.